my kid. You missed quite a time.
Aye. Bet you about Nassau and Blackbeard flying the coop.
Well, we'll see about Thatch. Vane's off to see him now, and I'm following soon.
This is what's left of your experiment in democracy.
Aye. We do as we please here, and we take our time doing it.
But for Christ's sake, Edward. Don't anything but the stink of riches wrinkle your nose.
What's got into you, man?
Reality, mate. Reality. See that you ain't pulled into the drink by this drowning rat.
Oi! I've lived longer than most men who trod this path.
What do you want, Englishman?
Edward Kenway. I'm here to warn you of danger. And I'm Welsh.
You all look the same to me. Why should I need your warning? My life is all danger.
I may have brought it on you.
This means you owe me. As it happens, I could use a man to help free some of my friends.
Slaves? You mean?
Brothers. Warriors. The hope of the Maroon.
Doesn't sound like my business, mate.
All I need is for you to mingle with your countrymen. Listen to hints for where my friends are held.
Fine. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. followed. We must warn the others.
The information I need, mate.
No! I've heard of your kind. Assassin, don't hurt me!
All I want to know is where this slave is. Do you know of anyone being held? Especially...
Please! Let me live. My wife and children.
Come on, then. Out with it.
Look near the windmill.
See? Was that so hard?
Where his brothers are kept. Help me release them.
No, mate. I've settled my debt. Meddling with slaves is none of my affair. I doubt there's even a Templar behind it all.
All affairs of freedom are assassins' affairs. What is your price?
What?
A man without principle must be moved by coin. How much do you need?
There is a key I'm looking for. Belongs to a set I've been stripping off Templars.
The Templar keys? I thought they'd been destroyed.
I'm not the only one who knows about them, then.
If we find it, it's yours.
You have a deal. Let's go get your friends.
The drunks and whores you called friends might help you now.
I'll pay me a patient here.
Thank you.
Hurry, to my bureau.
Exercise caution. The area will be well guarded. You know how this works. Take your position.
You're not
good to be. Thanks.
Meet me at the bureau.
Where to next?
That's enough work for one night. Or do you grow fond of it?
That's it. No Templar. What about the key?
The Templar did not show himself. You will have your key next time.
No, Anto, there is no next time.
When you discover your conscience, or admit how badly you want the key, there will be a next time. You returned. Have you brought your conscience?
I want my key.
Patience is a virtue.
Expecting company.
You may have your key sooner than you think. Help us defend the bureau. The men we freed will help. Before the next wave. Advance! As you can before the next wave. Retreat! Keep your heads low! There are so many of them still. We'll be tough. I'm glad you showed up when you did. I'm sorry I have no key to give you, but...
No, the key can wait. Whoever did this, I want to teach them a lesson.
The Templar's name is Kenneth Abraham. He's part of an ongoing war with the Maroons. But we have held strong and will not be defeated. Let me devise a plan. I have a plan, but it won't be easy. Abraham is well connected and his pockets are deep. But we have located a man in his inner circle. We will tail him until he reveals our target.
Let me bring him to his end.
Here he comes now.
Numbers are many. They will not stand a chance.
invited to see us celebrate for our victory.
Right.
Officers, may I join you?
Evening.
The more the merrier.
I've just come from the barracks. I'm quite certain the new weapons shipments will end our maroon problem once and for all.
That is the plan.
That is the plan.
Nobody expected it.
Most likely. They always do something wrong, but this time, it won't matter. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a private matter to attend before I make my entrance. As do I.
We will see you there.
Good evening. Will the commander be in attendance tonight?
Yes. I was just speaking with him. He is here somewhere.
The prat was right under our noses the whole time.
He's a slippery one. He won't behave like an ordinary soldier.
I say, you hear that horn, you're in trouble.
Bastards in me sight!
Hunter, how many years have we fought? Your men in the mountains with no weapons to speak of? My army, resplendent. And yet you live, and I die.
You lack the conviction to win.
Fire!
Time's up, sucker! A great disappointment you are, Thatch. His mind's made up to stay, he says. It's a sodding. And hang all of you lot that follow this sorry bastard into obscurity.
I know you're come to call me home, Kenway. And your faith in me is kind. But with Nassau done in, I feel I'm finished.
I'm not of the same mind, mate. But I won't begrudge you the state of yours.
You still looking for that sage fellow?
Aye.
Taking a prize a month back, I heard a man named Roberts was working a slave ship called the Princess. Might want to see about it.
The Princess. Cheers, Thatch.
Well, don't sit there like a barrel of wet fish. We're celebrating my retirement! Uncork this man's breakfast!
Out! Save us a few bottles, eh?
Where's it, lad?
Hello? Thatch? Lieutenant? You how are you?
What? Stay here. Shoot anything that moves.
There was a deserter among them who recalled my mace. I sliced into his gullet before any word left his lips. Sliced into his gullet before any word left his lips.
Anybody see?
Don't think so, sir. But I reckon Kenway suspects something. He don't list much.
Tell me about the siege.
A fair gathering, sir. Most too drunk to stand.
That will suit our purpose. Tell me about Edward. What sort of man is he?
It's Thatch, sir. At least that's what he calls himself. But he's a mad bugger, he is. Cracked as a glass teapot, sir.
Details now. Stop talking in gibberish.
Well, sir, he likes his drink for his use. Only he makes it worse. He takes the usual rum flip and fills it with half a weight of gunpowder to top it off.
Did I hear you right? He drinks gunpowder?
Aye, sir. Just for show. And only last week, he rounded up a score of his crew and bade us sit down of his ship while he burnt off sulfur and other sticking chemicals. We just sat there like it was one of a million pits of hell and nothing less ordinary.
Good God! What the hell for?
Like to test his crew is all. Tease out their fitness and what. Of course, it always turned out he was the fittest of the lot. Thought for a moment I'd die there. Bloody savages.
Have no fear, soldier. This will be the end of it. Come on. It's time. Quickly, send the signal. And remember always this day.
What the devil?
not fat, sir. Did he fall? Captain?
He drinks damnation.
So Thatch has been topped. Fuck's sake.
He was outnumbered. I couldn't reach him.
Devil damn the man, he was fierce, but his heart was divided.
It's hard to let go of the life you know best.
My own idiot father liked to brag about how he meant to purchase a ship of his own. I'll get a privateering contract, Charlie. Your old dad'll be a captain. Drowned in a whiskey bottle before he ever left shore. Right, Kenway. Been musing on this plan of yours. This observatory you're always going on about. How do we know it exists?
We find a slave ship called the Princess. Aboard should be a man called Roberts. He can lead us to it.
All them slavers work for the Royal African Company. Find one of their ships and start asking some questions.
Clues down! Catch some wind!
What's our course, Captain?
We're looking for slave ships. Any that work for the Royal African Company.
You don't mean to traffic human cargo now, do you?
No, Jesus, Adam. You know me better than that. We're only after information. Hope we'll find where the Princess docks in the spare time.
The Princess? The slave ship?
Right. Blackbeard told me there's a good chance we'd find Sage aboard her.
Sunk a merchant schooner.
Damn. Can't that animal stay the course we agreed to?
Captain! There's sea critters to spear here!
Lava, human!
Some fresh meat there if you can strike it, sir!
That slaver ship, can we? There's hundreds of innocent men aboard.
I know.
She's spooked, Captain! The slaver ship is running!
Damn fool!
I'll get it in close.
Damn that captain bin! He's unloading everything he has!
He'll sink it if he's not careful. We'll get closer.
Fire!
Awaiting order!
A ship, Kenway. There's hundreds of innocent men aboard.
I know.
You thirsty dogs, dinner!
We're going over. Find the captain.
Come at me, Roysters. You scurvy mac and brains.
Guns and steel aren't louder than sticks and spittle.
I'm more than enough of all that.
Just find the captain.
Yeah.
This captain claims the princess sails out of Kingston every few months.
Right. We'll set a course.
You made ash of my sails and rigging, jackanapes. You owe me a share.
Oh, damn it, Vane!
Oh, Charles, what a surly devil you are.
Don't fuck with me, Jack.
Oh, but it's my mandate to fuck with you, Charles.
Lads!
See, the boys and I had a bit of counsel while you were wasting time with this lot. And, well, they figured I'd be a fitter captain than you reckless dogs.
I'll cut you another cut, traitor!
This one I figure I might sell for a tenner down in Kingston. But with you two grog blossoms,
I can't take any chances. You regret this day, Rackham.
I regret most of them already. Tie them up! Cast them off.
I'll gut you, Jack Rackham! I'll open you up! I'll tear out your organs and string your bloody loot with them!
Stop your goddamn howling, Vane! There's no bloody use!
Well, well. The fierce of Edward Kenway speaks, eh? Pray tell us, Captain, how to quit this predicament. And tell us what genius you have for sailing a boat with no sails and no rudder.
Shut your gob!
Keep still now. I'll take these oysters you've ordered.
You mad sap. This island's crawling with food. If only you'd care to look for it.
Yeah, I am looking, louts. Found some just here. Don't come following now. Do you hear me? Don't come looking for me.
Wretched fool.
Thank you. Well done with the fishermen and their dories, Kenway! This island's mine! Come at me, and I'll cap you, bastard! It was your bloody imagination that landed us here, Kenway! I'll be damned if I let that mine make one more decision for me!
Will you not talk to me, Vane? Are you fixed on this madness?
Madness? Nothing mad about a man fighting to survive, is there?
I mean you no harm, you corker. Now let's work this out like gentlemen.
Oh, God, I've got a bleeding headache on account of your jabbering. Now stay back and let me live in peace.
I would if you stop filching the food I gather and the water I find.
I'll stop nothing till you bait me back in blood. You was the reason we were out looking for savers, and you was the reason Jack Rackham took my crew.
Aye, another keystone.
Yeah.
I said not to follow!
Jesus, you've lost your head, man!
It's a fair exchange for finding these flintlocks and grenados.
Listen, Vane. We can hunt with those guns.
And I mean to! Into this mess, Kenway. And I'll be damned if I let you drag me into another.
You keep this up, and I'll have to kill you, Vane.
Bloody try, by all means. It's either you or me who's leaving this island alive, Welsher! Because I'm not going to sail again in a world cursed by your ugly boat!
Aye, another keystone.
You can't hide, Kenway! Blow off some limbs! I'll blow you to hell! Nancy boy, you're done half a fucking job.
Fucking hell. Is this my reward for believing the best about men? For thinking that a bilge rat like you could muster up some fucking sense once in a while? Maybe Hornigold was right.
Maybe the world does need men of ambition to stop the likes of you from mucking it all up.
Or maybe you just don't have the stones to live with no regrets.
Don't save me a spot in hell, Shankar. I ain't coming soon.